Because languages like Dart support null, it can also lead to null exceptions. In this case, the girlfriend variable is null and we cannot execute a method on a null value. And this leads then to a crash of your application and the end user will not be happy about it. To activate null safety, you need to go to your pub/spec.jaml file and here you need to have at least the Dart version 2.12 inside. After this, make sure that you run flutter pub get. Now that we have null safety activated, all of our types are by default not nullable, which means they are requiring some value. So for example, a string, an integer, or also a color needs to have a real value. On the other hand, if you are trying to put a null value to a normal type, then it will lead to a compile error. Adding a question mark makes the type nullable and allows us to pass a null value to this field. So we can have now a real value or a null value if you have a question mark operator inside. Let's look at some real examples. First of all, we have null checks, which mean that Dart helps you to avoid null-related errors. In this case, the type string is not nullable and therefore we cannot put a null value inside. If we want to put a null value inside, then we add a question mark. And with this, we can pass a null to this method or also a real value. The compiler is now warning us that we cannot call the toUpperCase method because the nullable string value can also have a null value and therefore we need to make sure that we catch this null value. And with this, the compiler error will disappear. Next, we look at how we can convert between the type and the type question mark. So if you convert from the type to the type question mark, there is no problem, since the nullable type accepts real values and also a null value, and in our case we put every time a real value inside and therefore it is fine. Let's also look at the other case that we convert a nullable type to a type. And this is more problematic and the compiler is warning us that we cannot put a null value to a not nullable type. And we have now three possibilities to actually fix this issue. The first one is that we are checking if our variable is not null. And if our variable is null, then we are not executing the code below. And therefore this conversion is not triggered with the null value and we don't face any errors. Secondly, we can add a default value. So in case our nullable girlfriend variable is null, then we want to add this default value for our string. And with this, the compiler is not warning us anymore because we have a default value. And lastly, we can convert a nullable value to a not nullable value by using an exclamation mark. Lastly, if you don't pass a value to your type, then it gets here an error because it has by default a null value. However, if you have an initState method and inside of it you initialize this value, then the error is still there. And this is because Dart isn't clever enough to know that your value was initialized. And therefore you simply add a late keyword before your string, which means that your value is later initialized. And this late keyword is then later a promise to Dart that you are initializing this variable later with a real value. However, if you later then miss to initialize this value, then you didn't fulfill this promise to Dart and he will simply crash your application at the runtime level. Therefore, make sure that you have the initialization inside if you use the late keyword to prevent your app from crashing.